we're starting it now. Farm power, as we discussed in the previous class, the power energy is needed for everything. So right from every process, preparing the land for sowing the seed, maybe planting whatever crop it be. So we'll be starting those things. So the first and foremost power earlier we used to use is the manpower, human power. No? So we'll have this, what are the various activities, in our country. So we'll be using today mechanization to certain extent because the farmers of every small holding they have. So unka khet bahut kam hota hai. So the, as per the one statistics, the average land holding per farmer is around only 2 hectares. That means less than 5 acres land. So in the situation or in these circumstances, how are we going to improve our production? So how much are we going to gain? So definitely, as our civilization is increasing, majority of the people are shying away from the entering the fields. आजकल बहुत लोग इतना पसंद नहीं आते हैं खेत में काम करना इतना पसंद नहीं है. So they, everybody want to have a white collar job. So now under that circumstances, हमारा ये मकसद बनता है. As we discussed in the previous class, the population is increasing, the less hands are coming towards feeding all the mouths. So now we have to be making this as an industry. Now we are talking about agricultural industry. Agricultural sector is gaining the momentum. Okay, it will become an industry. So meaning, so maybe with whatever small land holding you have, a family can comfortably lead the life with clean air, clean water, and also becoming environment friendly. For improving that kind of farm output, we need to have definitely help of equipment, implements, and some sort of self-propelled equipment. So like tractors, power sprayers. Now we are all talking about incorporating a newer technology into agriculture. And we started talking about what is called a precision agriculture and technology-based agriculture and remote agriculture. So maybe I'm sitting in this university, probably my hometown is almost like 1,500 kilometers from here, but still I can guide my people to how to do the activity there. Maybe I'll be having some gadgets there, some machines they'll be doing as I instruct, as I program. They also observe, I'll be having some arrangement such that they'll be observing the plant's growth, whatever it's needed, maybe whether you need to feed the water or the nutrients or the pesticides. These are the three things which you need to have in order to have a better output. And it has to be monitored on day basis. Har din humko plant ka tabiyat ke bare mein jankari hona chahiye. So we cannot forget for a month or so, okay, I just sown something and I go for a All India tour and I'll come back and afterwards we'll see what is there kind of thing. So I say attitude nahi chalta agriculture. It's something like as a mother takes care of a small infant, how he'll be taking care of. So similarly, we should be taking care of all the crops which we have. So the normal agriculture. In the horticulture, there's a different ballgame altogether. Okay, so now let us move towards understanding what is the power, what are the different types of power we have. So that I can able to tell you, yeah, this slide, you can see what are the different sources of power available. So first, as I told you, it's a human power, and next animal power, third one is mechanical power, and fourth one is electrical power, and now focus is on, so we should be able to have our own power. How are you going to get that energy converted with the what is that we are producing? So these energies become a byproduct of our main product. Maybe you are just growing a paddy, so harvest the paddy, you get lot of haystack. सो उसको आप कुछ रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी तरीके से यूज कर सकते हैं. नॉट दैट वी आर सेइंग नाउ इवन इन बिहार आई कुड सी लॉट ऑफ फार्मर्स दे आर बर्निंग देयर सो कॉल्ड वेस्ट मे बी हैशटैग नो वॉट एवर द वेस्ट ऑफ योर प्रोडक्ट यू आर गेटिंग इट. सो विल नॉट बी थिंकिंग एनीथिंग वी प्रोड्यूस एवरीथिंग हैज टू बी यूज्ड बी इट्स अ रूट बी इट्स अ नो इट्स अ शेल नो पैडी का शेल हो सकता है उसका वी कॉल इट्स अ बार्न और द हस सब कुछ हम यूज कर सकते हैं इस्तेमाल कर सकते हैं. सो वी कैन कन्वर्ट दैट इंटू एनर्जी. सो यू नो कैन मी हम यूज करते थे हमारे बचपन में भी आई मीन आई हैव सीन माय ड्यूरिंग माय चाइल्डहुड एंड नाउ आल्सो व्हेनेवर आई गो especially paddy when you just use the harvesting techniques so you have to separate the actual grain and which is not of fully formed shells so you use you segregate those things so with the help of wind energy. So today we use power tillers with a big fan attached to it and that will be forced towards now when you take it and put it then that will be make separating the lighter grains away and
chaffy seeds
okay so you have to forgive me I just I have to get used to this technology so probably I can do that so like that we'll be having it anyway you know the paddy cultivation so that everything we can make use of it. So now moving on to the other thing, you know, where in all we'll be using the human power. So this is the nursery, transport, and paddy transplanting. So the average manpower is about 1 kilowatt. You know, up to 1 kilowatt energy one can use it. So in the farm work, the male will have a better resilience so that they can work for longer hours. And women, by the anatomy of their body itself, so they are well suited for certain particular tasks. But of late, we are employing this manual labor for everything, no? So they can do it. But we have to give them some tools such that whatever energy they have, with that energy, they could be able to multiply the energy and then get the work done, like implements, agricultural implements. So now moving on to the animal power. Okay, so you are all aware of because most of the we are all belongs to mostly rural India. So we have been noticing and seeing how we are using the cattle and all sorts of animals we used in the agriculture. In some areas. Donkeys also are used, and in Rajasthan, etc., we'll be using camels for some activities. You know, so whatever that's you can able to tame the animals, whatever animal you can able to tame, so all those animals can be used for our farm. But most commonly used are bullocks and oxes. You know, so these are the things, and horse and other things now very expensive for us to buy. So earlier there used to be. You know, for everything we started using. Mechanical power, you know, mechanical power. You understand, right? So you will be using to propel your bus, truck, train, including even the aircrafts. You know, so space launch vehicles, PSLV. Yesterday also it was successful. You know, it launched successfully. So far no failures in the past 25 years or so since we're just using these space launch vehicles. So tractors, particularly when you come to the agriculture sector, so we use tractors, power tillers, and self-propelled combines. You know, harvesters also we have now. For many purposes we'll be using it, and we'll be examining each one at a time. So the best prime mover or the power source for this power tiller or tractor. Is called internal combustion engine. So internal combustion engine is also called as heat engine. That belongs to a family of heat engines. So heat engine, heat as the name it goes, heat is a form of energy. So particularly, whenever you burn anything which is a combustible having the carbon content, so they are all generate the convert the energy from that solid particle, burning particle, into heat energy. And whenever, depending on the heat energy, magnitude of heat energy, there's a quality and then quantity of heat energy, you'll be having what is called as temperature. So you'll be understanding by measuring the temperature, you say what is the energy content of this particular heat. So we'll be using that heat energy to propel your prime mover or the tractor or power tiller or bus, truck, whatnot. So this heat, how we convert that into mechanical power? That is, ultimately, this has to be converted into, this heat energy must be converted into mechanical energy. So in all practical purposes, this mechanical energy is available in the form of shaft energy. No? Shaft energy, rotating shaft energy. So we have some other arrangements in between gear, etc. So we'll be having this one particular shaft rotating. So this is the place from where you can propel your wheels, road wheels, or the cage wheels, whatnot, all those things will be having it. So again, coming back to the heat engines is one category. In that, broadly, we divide all the heat engines into two categories. One is external combustion engine, other one is internal combustion engines. So if both the type of heat engines will be using the farm field. In the farm field, we use both. External combustion engines also we do use, as well as internal combustion also we use. And external combustion gadgets we use, wherever you need to process your agriculture produce, like a boilers, you will be having the steam generation, for drying and other things also we'll be using it. That we'll discuss after some time, okay? So out of these two types of broadly, heat engines are divided into two categories. One is the external combustion engine, other one is internal combustion engines. Now, let us talk about only internal combustion engines because they occupy a larger portion of our power requirements, our energy requirements for farming in the agriculture particularly. So internal combustion engines, again, we have a big classification based on the fuel we use. If we use a diesel oil, we call that as a diesel engine. Based on the fuel, we have a classification of engines. Internal combustion engines classified based on the fuel used. One is petrol, petrol engine, diesel engine. And sometimes we start a diesel engine or the petrol engine with kerosene, then switch out to the other one. So we have that kind of things also, especially we used to use earlier. Now, of course, this power sprayers to spray the pesticides, etc. We used to use the power sprayers. Those power sprayers are powered by small internal combustion engines. Now, we replace this internal combustion engines with the electrical one, the battery operated power sprayers we have today. So that is the progress we made. So in the case of those power sprayers powered by the engines, IC internal combustion engines, they used to start with first putting petrol. You still have two fuel tanks. One fuel tank was smaller in size because you need petrol only to start the engine. Once you start the engine, then put up the petrol supply and on the kerosene or the diesel. So then this engine runs. Okay. So that's where such kind of engines are called as a dual fuel engines. That means it is a multi-fuel capability that a particular engine has. So we have purely diesel engines, purely petrol engines, and also dual fuel engines. More than one fuel can be used in them by design. So in the farm field, mostly we resort to the diesel engines, because the diesel is relatively cheaper and gives you better rate of energy than the petrol. Maybe you might have just experienced that with your two wheelers. The petrol vehicle or the car gives you maybe say 15 kilometers per liter of fuel. A diesel engine gives you around 20 plus kilometers per liter fuel. That means same volume, you get more mileage in this, in the diesel, and less mileage in the petrol engines. So meaning, in order to operate stationary engines, maybe you use a pump set powered by a diesel engine. So in the stationary engines, we don't measure the efficiency of the engine or the performance of the engine in terms of kilometers. In the stationary engines, we measure its performance based on how many liters of fuel it consumes in order to do the required work per hour. So that's the based on the fuel consumption rate. In 1 hour, how many liters of fuel it is consuming? For the same work, a petrol engine consumes little more fuel. That means, in order to operate petrol engine is expensive. Yeah, हमारे लिए महंगा पड़ता है. इसलिए farm field में हम इसका इस्तेमाल नहीं करते हैं. That's based on fuel used. How many types are? Three types. Internal combustion is of three types based on the fuel used. One is diesel engine. That engine uses diesel as a fuel. Petrol engine that uses petrol as a fuel. Dual fuel engine, maybe any combination of these two also can be used. Now, you might have seen that pump set either that will be having one cylinder engine or two cylinder engine. No, or three kind of thing. Based on the number of cylinders we have, for example, tractors are available in the various power range, as low as 5 HP to 200 HP. So, in order to make that engine built small and compact, and also increase the power output, will be increasing the number of cylinders. So where the fuel is ignited and that will be burnt. We'll be talking about it in the due course of time. So we'll be having number of cylinders. The construction of the engine, basically an engine like a human body, like you have got a head, you know, this body is like a cylinder, and you have what is called as where you'll be converting the reciprocating, the cylinder will be having a piston that will be reciprocating like this. Okay, this reciprocatory motion has to be converted to rotary motion, circular rotating motion, and that is made possible using crank and connecting rod mechanism. So the reciprocatory motion of the piston is converted into a rotary motion using a mechanism called connecting rod and crankshaft mechanism. So this reciprocatory motion is becoming a rotary motion at the mechanical end. This is the one which we'll be using as a useful energy. So now, having known what is a cylinder kind of thing, the cylinder will be having piston, and cylinder is covered on the top. So that's called the cylinder head. So this cylinder head, based on the type of engine, will be having either the injector to inject the fuel into the cylinder, or a spark plug. Probably you might have seen in your two wheelers, you'll be having one spark plug. So when the fuel gets into the cylinder during some cycle of operation, you'll be having that what is the mechanism, how it will be running kind of thing in the due course of time. Okay, so first understand what are the components you'll be having it. So cylinder, piston, connecting rod, crankshaft, and crankcase. Now, these are the major components of the engine. What are they? Cylinder. In the cylinder, piston reciprocates, two components. Then piston is connected to the small end of connecting rod. And at the other side of the connecting rod, you have a big head, you know, big head. So this will be rotating like this. You know? The reciprocating motion is converted to rotary using this is the crankshaft. like your bicycle. How you have a crank? So similar to that, it will be having that rotation. Okay. So these are the just mechanisms. Now, based on the number of cylinders, single cylinder, we call a single cylinder engine. You have got two cylinders for the same engine, common crankshaft. Then we say that the two cylinder engine or the twin cylinder engine. Likewise, three cylinders, we have four cylinders. Number of cylinders can be increased. You know, even we got a 12 cylinder engines too. So meaning, we are going to build a compact system and increase the power because there is a limitation. Each cylinder has got some limit. So beyond which it cannot able to generate the required power. When you need to have a more power, then we'll be having adding number of cylinders like this. If you need more, then we'll be going for two cylinder engine. If you need more power than the, then say, first you need 5 HP, maybe single cylinder engine will do. Now up to 7.5, normally we'll be having a single cylinder engine. And because we are talking about station engines now, okay. So if you need more power than 7.5 HP, say 10 kilowatts, then you'll be needing multi-cylinder engines, which is called multi-cylinder engines. More than one cylinder, no, based on number of cylinders, we have two types. One is single cylinder engine, other one is multi-cylinder engines. This multi, that number may be anything. You know, you can have 2, 3, 4, you know, tall kind of thing. So here, condition is a common crankshaft. You know, common crankshaft. That is the single cylinder engine, based on number of cylinders, single cylinder engine and multi-cylinder engine. So what is that we have seen now? Two different classification of engines, based on fuel and based on number of cylinders. Again, the arrangement of cylinders, you have got number of cylinders, wonderful, good. How are you going to have it? Based on the arrangement of number of cylinders, alignment, how you are having it? Either like this, 1, 2, 3, 4 kind of in one line, like this, if you see the cylinders, 1, 2, 3, 4 cylinders, like this, or like this. You could see the V, one cylinder here, other cylinder is here. That means there are in the same line. So if you have like this, the line is like this. And if I have this, then like this, and like this, two cylinders here, and two cylinders here. So it's a, it forms V, right? It forms V. So based on the cylinder arrangement, we have inline cylinder arrangement. Other one is V type. There are only two types. So there's another classification of IC engines. So likewise, we'll be having, based on the, in order to complete, in your slide, you can see the title is mechanical power. Where you are going to get the power? It's something like I can compare with a human being. So you eat food, right? You are taking food. So likewise, we supply fuel into the engine cylinder. How it is going to be converted into heat energy? And that heat energy again converted into mechanical energy. So this mechanical energy we are tapping as a shaft power, shaft energy. That's a power. Okay. So now, what happens inside the cylinder? So before that, let's understand why we have the piston and the crankshaft and connecting rod. Let's understand. So in the engine, the cylinder is there. It will have a cover. No, it's an enclosed one. Okay. So like we take food, we send the fuel into the cylinder. When? So the piston has to move up and down. That we have already discussed. We'll be having the reciprocal motion of the piston, how it is going to move on its own, you know. So in order to complete one cycle of operation, what is the cycle of operation here? So there will be four distinctive activities happens in the engine cylinder. Engine cylinder, the fuel, it just enters, that is, it has to suck in. Like we breathe in, so likewise, that sucks in the ingredients which are needed to assist the combustion of fuel. You know the mechanism of burning. So for example, I tell you, maybe you can experiment that, but with care. I take a small cylinder like this, no, small bottle, whatever, glass bottle, put the petrol in it. Okay. So what that will be doing? Light the matchstick and dip into the fuel beaker. You have petrol, you know, that burns, right? But you take the matchstick, okay, dip into it. What happens? Whether petrol burns, the fuel burns, it's a petrol, you know, it burns. Somebody can unmute and then answer me. You know, those who would like to respond back, you can do it. Are getting my point? Say there's a beaker, a small beaker, because it's a safety question comes into picture. Maybe when you come back to college, I'll just show you that too. Okay. So when you come to your class, I'll just show you. So take a small beaker like this, whatever. Okay, you have a small portion filled in, half full. If you just light the matchstick and put at the distance, not on the surface. No, this is a surface here. Is you put on the top. Maybe you can see some flame coming. No, it just vanishes. It just burns very quickly and then vanishes. And you take the lighting matchstick. ये बर्न होता रहता है ना मैच स्टिक अप्लाई करने के बाद फ्लेम तो रहता है इसका देन पुट इनटू द पेट्रोल इट शुड कैच द फायर राइट बट इट विल नॉट बिकॉज दैट डाइज इन ऑर्डर टू परफॉर्म दिस एक्टिविटी ऑफ कंबशन बर्निंग यू नीड टू इंग्रेडिएंट्स द फर्स्ट इंग्रेडिएंट इज फ्लेम सेकंड इंग्रेडिएंट इज यू नो इट यू स्टडीड दैट इन फिजिक्स राइट दैट इज There's oxygen you need. No, two things you need. So these two. Yeah, what is Dinbandhu? You wanted to ask? You can ask me.
Sorry, sir. Ho gaya.
Sorry? Disturb. Okay, take it. Not a problem. Samajh aa raha hai na? Hum kya keh rahe?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. No, fuel and you need to have oxygen. From where you get the oxygen? In the air. In the air, majority, almost 35% or so, you have oxygen. Maybe now I'm doubtful, which you have. So you need to have oxygen. So there's a chemical reaction happens. Carbon plus oxygen gives you the carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide kind of thing, liberating the heat. So we need to have that. So you'll have a chemical equilibrium balance kind of thing in the equation. And also some water vapor also comes. So this is the mechanism there. So this inhale applicable burning. So the process, like you inhale the oxygen. Okay. So likewise, when the piston at the top end, it has to, when it's just moving down, that creates some sort of vacuum inside, you know, anything like an injection. Doctor, I think you might have seen the, you have gone to the doctor sometime, you might have taken the injection. So how they just, load the injector. So they take something like this, push into the, injector needle is pushed into the bottle and then they pull it down, right? So how that gets filled in that liquid, similarly, there'll be opening for air intake into the cylinder. So when the piston is at the, on its top, in the vertical engine cylinders, again, vertical and horizontal, two types of engines are there, but anyway, normally we're using only vertical engines. So this is at the top. So the gap between the head and this is very small. When the piston starts moving, it just sucks kind of thing. It just sucks the air from outside. So that sucks in. At particular point, in the case of diesel engine, so this sucks. It just, once that cylinder is full, it just comes to the bottom. Then it starts moving. Then at that point of time, that nozzle, it just sucking in, that stops. Now every vent is closed, the piston starts moving upwards. So already you have some air inside now, and that starts getting compressed. That air starts getting compressed by this air. you know what happens in the compression? Whenever you compress in a limited area, larger volume, the temperature of the fluid, whatever you have, air or whatever, that temperature increases. So that temperature may be going beyond what is a property of any fuel is called. There's one ignition or fire point and flash point kind of thing for a fuel. So they go to the temperature wherein the fuel gets ignited. You know, when the diesel another went down, when this entire thing cylinder full of air now is being compressed by the moving upward moving piston, and it's about to reach top dead center, the volume, the full volume may be say 1 liter, and that 1 liter volume of air is reduced to only 10 milliliters of air. That means it's a 1000 ml, 1 liter is 1000 ml. 1000 ml of air is reduced to only 10 ml. That means you can understand what is the ratio of compression there. Like, you know, it just compresses it. So that heat generates. Normally it is 1:12 in the case of petrol engine, and in case of diesel engines it is 1:21 minimum. Minimum. That means 21 times pressure goes. That means it's reduced by 21 times. Suppose you have got, say, 1 liter, now reduce into 20 parts or 21 parts or 26 parts. So each part, what is the size? So that much only is compressed. Okay, that's the top. It just goes a small volume. At that instant, this whatever fluid you have here, that gets very hot because of compression process. At that moment, the injector opens and injects a metered quantity, measured quantity of fuel being injected into. That depends on what is called as this air and fuel will be maintaining one ratio. And we call that air-fuel ratio or fuel-air ratio, whatever you can call. So one quantity of fuel will be having, depends. So theoretically, what is it we call? A lean mixture, rich mixture, three different types of ratios will be having. One is lean mixture, rich mixture, other one is chemically correct mixture strength. Chemically correct mixture strength. That means how much exactly you need in order to have the full combustion, complete combustion. That much will be having it. So lean mixture means less fuel, more oxygen. Rich mixture means less oxygen and more fuel than the required to complete the combustion. So rich mixture meaningless. That's what you have seen whenever it raise your motorbike, you know, accelerator suddenly, you can see thick clouds of smoke comes through the exhaust. That means you'll be having a lot of energy being lost in the form of incomplete combustion that gets exhausted during the yet another process called. So in the combustion process, in the engine cylinder cycle, you'll have 4 processes. One is intake process. No, we have to take intake. Other one is compression process. Third one is combustion. And that's the power stroke, power process. Then fourth one is exhaust process. Exhaust process. How many processes we have? 4. What are they? Suction, that's intake. Then follows compression. Then immediately here, the burning takes place. The third process, combustion. Because of combustion, a lot of energy released. Suddenly it's like an explosion kind of thing. Then that thrusts upon the piston. Because this is the only component which is left. It's a poor job. Now the entire energy is moved towards this. Then this is pushed down. This is the power stroke. No? The piston moves down. When? There's a third process. It's coming down. So once it's about to reach the bottommost portion, that's end of travel. This is the bottom of the cylinder. Then it's about to move down, then exhaust opens. So as it is, inside the cylinder, the combustible matter already burned and having at higher pressure than the outside pressure. Any small vent, it will be waiting for, like you will be attending physical classes. Whenever this class completes, we have to go out, kind of feeling will be having, right? Whenever you have to go to class. So, No, no, I'm just taking example of students. Okay, not even 5 minutes now, I think. Okay, anyway, so this is something like a boring class at times. So we'll be looking for watches, right? When this class gets over, I can just jump out of the classroom kind of thing. So this burnt gases inside the cylinder having higher pressure, they'll be waiting for some opportunity to get some opening. And at that instant, that exhaust valve or the opening opens, or the port opens, okay? So because of that pressure difference between the atmosphere and inside the pressure cylinder, that gets out. And in order to push it, you know, in order to drain it, in order to flush everything out, so the piston, when it's moving, above moving piston, now it moves towards the top. That piston pushes out all the things, that is flushing out all the burnt gases. No? So that's how it completes four processes. One is suction, other one is compression, third one is the combustion process, and last one is exhaust process. So likewise, we'll bank four processes in the engine. So out of these four processes, the third process is the power. That's the combustion process is the one which gives us the energy. That energy is converted into mechanical power using the crankshaft and crank mechanism. And now comes to the third point on your slide. Okay. The thermal efficiency of diesel engine varies from 32 to 38%, whereas that of the petrol, you can see efficiency is 25 to 32%. I think that's what I told you before too. So that's the reason why you use diesel engines. But unfortunately, most of the time, diesel engine in its emission gives out what is a particular parameter that's a bit disturbing for the environment is called PM, particulate matter. So there's a thick, like your ash particle, you know, ash particles, it just emits. And we call that as a pollution. Whereas petrol engine too produces the pollution, but that not be having this visible pollution, you know, that visible pollution, but it will have
Yes, sir.
Any doubt?
No, sir.
Yes, sir. What is the meaning of fish?
Sorry? What is the meaning of?
Piston.
Piston is the one component which is a moving component. I'll just show you in the next slide. Okay. I'll just show you next slide. No, I think you have to see the injection syringe, na? And the doctor gives you the injection. What he just pulls down. Yes. You have seen the injection injection? So that is the piston there. The doctor's hand will be having, na? One is a cylinder, barrel kind of thing, yes, like a aerator pipette. And you'll be having something inside. It's called as a plunger or the piston kind of thing. No? I'm just giving you some picture, no? That idea, how the piston looks like. So that creates a seamless, no, there's no gap between the cylinder inner liner, no, that inner surface and the piston. So that creates vacuum. When you just pull down, that creates vacuum. And vacuum, the true vacuum never exists. Something or the other rushes into filling that vacuum. So that's what you see in the syringe. How doctor takes the, or nurse takes the, like, you know, fluid into the syringe from the bottom, no, fluid, it just takes an injection. So similarly, we have a piston. Piston is a one which creates required vacuum. Okay, and the piston is connected to the small end of connecting rod. I'll just show you the. Okay, next class, I think day after tomorrow, I'll just show you Saturday. Okay, that engine components, I'll just show you. Okay.
सर ये जो इंजन होता है वन सिलेंडर कितने एचपी का होता है
नो
जैसे कि इंजन में चार सिलेंडर
फ्रैक्शनल एचपी बोलते हैं no, fraction yeah. HP, like a 1 HP to 7.5 HP in the agriculture field. I'm using this type of things. Lift connectly, like water lift connectly. Okay, normally for the pumps we'll use it.
Sir, engine तो कार में तो इस सिलेंडर इंजन का लीटर से ना नापा जाता है सर
मतलब कि
गाड़ी का इंजन के लिए
लीटर से या
नो नो नहीं लीटर के लिए इंजन कार का होती है ना सर
कार का भी इट डिपेंड्स वी हैव फॉर एग्जांपल मारुति 800 मतलब उनका सिलेंडर का साइज होता है 800 सीसी क्यूबिक सेंटीमीटर
जी
हाँ अभी देख लीजिए इधर
हम
दिखा रहे आपको इसका 18 सिलेंडर टू स्ट्रोक इंजन है ये बहुत बड़ा इंजन होता है 18 सिलेंडर का ओके दिस इज व्हाट इज द फोर स्ट्रोक इंजन डीजल इंजन होता है इधर देख रहे हैं
सर इसमें चार सिलेंडर है इसमें
नहीं नहीं दो होता है अब बोलता हूँ आपको ये तो फोर स्ट्रोक बोल रहे इधर स्ट्रोक का ये भी एक है इधर फोर स्ट्रोक है इधर टू स्ट्रोक है मगर देख लीजिए 18 सिलेंडर टू स्ट्रोक इंजन दिस वन इज द एरो इंजन दिस एयरक्राफ्ट इंजन 18 सिलेंडर टू स्ट्रोक इंजन ओके सो ये ट्रैक्टर में होता है कम से कम दो सिलेंडर होता है ट्रैक्टर में कम से कम दो सिलेंडर से चार सिलेंडर होता है आपका मारुति इंजन 80 सीसी बोलते ना 80 सीसी बोलते 800 सीसी आपका पीछे मारुति का एक लगता ना और क्या बोलते उसका स्टिकर तो 800 सीसी बोलते मारुति 800 मारुति 800 मतलब 800 सीसी
कार में तो सर गाड़ी मारुति 800 ये सब में सीसी नहीं लिखा लीटर लिखा रहता है सर इंजन का उसी जैसे कि
नहीं सीसी का मतलब वही दैट्स 0.8 लीटर ना सीसी मतलब वॉल्यूम वॉल्यूम का वॉल्यूम होता है ना एक लीटर बोलते हैं हम एक लीटर का कितना सीसी होता है 1000 सीसी होता है
सर इसमें पिस्टल तो शो कर रहा है ना सर इसे बता दीजिए पिस्टल यहाँ पे शो कर रही है ना
इधर इधर
येलो वाला या सर
ये पिस्टन है ये कनेक्टिंग रॉड है दिस द क्रैंक दिस इज द क्रैंक नाउ दिस कॉल्ड क्रैंक शाफ्ट इसका बोलते क्रैंक इतना डिस्टेंस है ना फ्रॉम हियर टू हियर दिस द क्रैंक आई जस्ट शो यू सम एनिमेशन इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास ओके आपका
यस
कुछ एनिमेशन भी दिखा लेता हूँ आपका क्लास हो तो हम बहुत बढ़िया दिखा सकते थे फिर भी ठीक है आपको एक एनिमेशन भी देखा जाता है इंजन का तो ये इसका बोलते हैं बिग एंड ऑफ द कनेक्टिंग रॉड ये तो स्मॉल एंड बोलता है इसका ये बिग एंड ऑफ द कनेक्टिंग रॉड बोलते हैं ये अप एंड डाउन करते हैं पिस्टन समझ में आ रहा है आपको देख रहे हैं यारो
यस यस सर
यू आर द पॉइंट you can see
this point
this is the one up and down okay this piston goes up and down whereas this oscillates connecting crankshaft oscillates like this there's a movement okay so ye hai na ye point rotates this rotates like this iska kya hota hai ये रेडियस बोलते हैं आप इतना रेडियस ये डिस्टेंस है ना ये रेडियस होता है सो दिस आर टू आर इक्वल टू द लेंथ ऑफ ट्रैवल ऑफ द पिस्टन इधर से इधर तक पिस्टन मूव होता है आप देख रहे हैं एबल टू सी एवरीथिंग Can you able to see this?
Yes, sir.
Huh? So this is the vertical distance the piston travels. A piston, है ना ये? This piston travels. Okay. We can remove this also, sir.
Yes. Then go to next slide.
Okay.
Then we'll ask key for us.
Okay. Anyway, the efficiency decreases. I'll just give you those things tomorrow. Okay. Next class. So in more, no, now we are all going for towards the use of mechanization. Bahut sare hote hain. Okay. So diesel engines are basically used for irrigation, flour mills, oil gunnies, now all cotton gins, the food processing we be use karte hain field mein. Okay. So a lot many things, even lawn mowers, whatnot, sugarcane crushers, no thrashers bolte hain na, aap harvest karte hain field mein, uska bhi hum istemal karte hain. So these are the different types, like you know, applications. Ye pura application nahi hai. Okay. So iske bhi zyada hum istemal karte hain. आपको पूरा लिस्ट भी दे देता हूं आपको. ऐसे आप इधर यूनिवर्सिटी के आने के बाद हर चीज आपके साथ क्या बात कर रहा मैं आपको आपके साथ करवा के दिखाता हूं. समझ में आपको? डन. सो नाउ इट्स अ टाइम अप आई थिंक सो. ओके, वी विल डिस्कस रिमेनिंग थिंग्स इन द सैटरडे क्लास. ओके, एवरी ऑल्टरनेट आई विल बी टेकिंग योर क्लास ट्यूजडे, Thursday and Saturday. Okay, same time, 10 o'clock. Is that okay? Thank you. Thank you for your all time. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. 11:30, sir will take. After sir will take.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, my dear. All the best.